Maria Martinez is perhaps the most influential Native American potter in the 20th century. Maria lived in the San Ildefonso Pueblo, close to Santa Fe, New Mexico, with her family, including her husband Julian and her son Popove Day, who would later be the governor of San Ildefonso. She was a very social person and fluently spoke her native Hopi language, English, and Spanish. Maria wanted to preserve the art of traditional Hopi pottery, so she did not use a potter's wheel or a kiln. Instead, she made her pottery using the process of coiling and firing her pots in a pit firing. Maria was resourceful, using the materials that were available to her, such as the clay that she dug herself in the desert, and the pottery tools that she made from items like gourds and plant fronds. She even used a burnishing stone that had been passed down to her by her aunt Nicolosa, who taught her to make pottery. Maria and her husband Julian made pottery together. Maria made the pots, and Julian decorated them. In her early work, they were polychrome pots, which were usually red clay decorated with colorful slips. After an excavation by Edgar Lee Hewitt discovered black pottery made by Native Americans, Maria began using a process known as carbon deposition to turn her pots black. Maria was a humble person. At first, she and Julian did not sign their work at all. After Julian died, her sons Popove Day and Adam and their daughter-in-law Santana helped her to make pottery. Although there is no record of her birth, we believe that Maria was around 100 years old when she died in 1980. Some of her pottery is the most famous in the world.